Right, what's going on, guys? It's AK from the Super Asian Buzz. What I have for you guys right now is a review of the iFrog's Lux for the iPad. Now, this case is pretty much the exact same thing for the iPhone 3G. It was one of my favorite slider cases for the iPhone 3G. It's very, very protective, it's very, very stylish, and I love the feel of the texture. So, before I get into this video, I want to thank iFrogs for sending this case over, along with many of other products they sent over for review. Thank you, iFrogs. Check them out, link in the description. I think they have the iPhone 4 cases out as well. Check them out, link in the description. They do have iPad cases, obviously. Check them out, link in the description. All right. So this is the iFrog's Lux in blue for the iPad. All right, now it features this really, really nice soft touch to it, same as the iFrog's Lux for the iPhone 3G. Now this texture is throughout the case. Pretty much the whole case is this texture. This is a two-piece slider case, so to take this case off, what I do is I just pull at one of the corners, then the opposite, then the other, then the opposite, then the other, and until you get to a point where you get, just a little gap, and then I just pull the rest off like that. Now, this is one of the features the iFrog's Lux has, is this nice felt pad on the inside. They have this with the other iFrog's Lux for the iPhone 3G as well. All right, and definitely now no worries of scratches in on the iPad. All right, and then here is the other piece, slides off really nicely. There is the other felt pad right there in the inside. All right, so obviously to put it on, it's just simple. Slide on the top piece and then get the bottom piece and slide on the bottom piece right there. Let's go over the port. The bottom, there's a full cutoff for the speakers right here, full cutoff for the dock. You can get to the vibrate sit or the landscape and portrait mode switch pretty easily. Volume rockers, you can get to that. They have a nice big cutoff for the sleep wake button and also the headphone jack right here. Now this case does have a really, really big lay on the table design. It might be actually a little bit bulkier than usual with the lay on the table design. Like right here, you could pretty much see through the case. They could have, slimmed down a little bit on this case, but it is still a really a great case. So using this case for the past probably 2 weeks, I've had no problems with this case. This case is a really, really nice case. It has that really nice feel to it, which is real why I really like holding it in my hands. When I do hold my hands, I usually just kind of pet it, which is kind of weird, but I really like the feel to this. Same thing as when I had my iPhone 3G. I always, kind of touch the back whenever I could. I know that might be weird, but that's the nature of having a soft feel case. You have a soft feel case because, it feels good. So now there's only one minor complaint I had about this is what's the lay on the table design right here. Like I said, it is a little bulkier than usual. So on the home button right here, you can see that it does have a nice ledge right there. So sometimes when I do go to hit the home button, it kind of gets in my way, but that's the only minor thing. And like I said, it is pretty minuscule. There's not really a big problem with it. So thank you, iFrost, for sending this case over for review. Check them out, link in the description. Thanks, iFrost, again, and thank you guys for watching.